It seems that AMD is on such a rise that even NZXT decided to pop their cherry and make an AMD motherboard. But I have so many questions though. For instance, number one, why is it on the B550 chipset and not the flagship X570 chipset the way they have done with their Intel motherboard? How does it stack up against motherboards from more seasoned motherboard manufacturers? And finally, will it bottleneck my Ryzen 95900X? Today, let's try to answer all those questions as we review the NZXT N7 B550 motherboard. One thing for sure is that it will never make your mother bored, but it might make her disappear. Editor, disappear. Like magic. I know that some of you guys probably think that a casings manufacturer like NZXT should just stick to their lanes and make more casings and coolers and stuff like that. To those of you guys, I just have something to say, which is, cannot meh? They like need your permission meh? But honestly, I think they were probably just too bored. Jokes aside, sometimes magic does happen when a brand gets out of their comfort zone, and I've always liked all the products that NZXT has put out so far. Touch wood. Today, let's find out if this thing sucks, or is it going to just be good at making your money disappear? Because it's so good, you just have to buy it to get it. Walao, today this script, who write one? Why the jokes all so horrible one? Making me tell dad jokes. Kids, if you love your daddies, please share this video to them because they can definitely use a laugh during these difficult times. The NZXT N7 B550 motherboard is priced at a whopping 1039 ringgit or $230, which is pricier than most of your B550 motherboards. And instead of calling it something menacing like godlike or extreme or strict, they called it N7. That's all you get. NZXT, I totally see what you did there. You rebel, you. In terms of aesthetics, NZXT is also keeping it simple with a metal shroud covering most of the motherboard except for the area surrounding the CPU socket and a pattern of perforated dots atop the north and south bridges. It has a matte finish with what seems to be powder coating and comes in not only white but also black. To be honest, sometimes motherboard manufacturers can go a little bit overboard with the aggressive gamer aesthetic, so I'm quite a big fan of this minimalist approach, but it might not be to everyone's taste. If you're a fan of NZXT, however, then rest assured that the excellent paint job on this motherboard pairs extremely well with their H-series cases. This is especially a concern for people who love white builds, but because not all white is created equal. One tiny detail that I find pretty cool is that the M.2 covers are magnetically attached, so you won't have to deal with extra screws, but the M.2 installation itself still requires screws. NZXT, if you're watching this, do consider making that toolless as well, because me and a bajillion other PC enthusiasts will definitely thank you for that. As far as RGB is concerned, there are none integrated, but it does come with a single 3-pin and 4-pin RGB header each, along with a pair of 4-pin NZXT RGB headers on the board. So there's still plenty of connection points for bling bling to be controlled via their CAM software. In terms of specifications, I'm not gonna bore you with all the B550 chipset features that you should be pretty familiar with by now. So I'm just gonna leave it up here so you can pause and have a read. Done? Got it? Okay, let's move on. I'm gonna point out some higher end features that I think came with this motherboard and were previously more reserved for the higher end X570 motherboards. Firstly, you get a 12+2 CPU power phase, which should prevent bottlenecks with higher end CPUs. You also get a 6-layer PCB compared to 4 on the older Z490 motherboard. Next, we have a large, no such thing as overkill, L-shaped metal block that cools the power delivery. Good network connectivity such as Bluetooth 5.2 and the brand new Wi-Fi 6E, as well as a boatload of USB ports, which makes this a very good work/play motherboard for content creators. So here are the specifications to our test bench. The reason why I didn't go with a Ryzen 5 processor is because this motherboard is actually pretty pricey and I want to see if it would actually bottleneck the performance on our Ryzen 9 5900X. To our surprise, it performed really admirably. With our 280mm AIO cooler, it managed to boost our CPU up to 4.8GHz occasionally, which means that it's actually performing to spec. Also, when it comes to overclocking, I managed to get all cores to be running at 4.5GHz at a reasonable voltage with minimal tweaking. So that's pretty good. Finally, I popped in two more modules of DDR4 RAM and ran four sticks of 8GB DDR4 memory at 3600MHz, which is a sweet spot for AMD right now. Here are some benchmarks with us putting the system through its paces. We even included real-world benchmarks with Adobe Premiere Pro, After Effects, and DaVinci Resolve for you content creators out there. So what's the verdict? Okay, let's take a look at the pros first. Firstly, we have a very good VRM design, which means that it will not bottleneck even a Ryzen 9 processor. And it has a boatload of USB ports on the board as well as on the I/O itself. And speaking of I/O, the I/O connectivity is great. You have more ports that you will ever need. And although it doesn't have integrated RGB, the RGB connector options here is also great. Then we have the great network connectivity options, including a brand spanky new Wi-Fi 6E. And finally, it has a very minimalist aesthetics, which actually makes it stand out. Next, we have the meh. Okay, and that is that this motherboard doesn't have integrated RGB. But that is really subjective because I personally like it, you might not, and that is why it's a meh. Finally, we have the cons, and there's just one, is that this thing is pretty pricey at 1,039 ringgit or $230. I give the NZXT N7 B550 motherboard a very solid cheap buy until mother cannot recognize, 8 out of 10. Honestly, this is one of the nicest B550 motherboards on the market with a price tag to match. But if you're somebody who needs a lot of USB ports, then you will think that, well, the price will justify itself. For most of you guys who use a GPU, a high-end GPU, as well as maybe one PCIe 4.0 M.2 slot, this is more than enough. If you're somebody who needs more PCIe lanes or even more flexible storage options, then you would have to go for X570 because that's more your speed. Another thing that you should never worry about is that this power design is definitely adequate to even power a Ryzen 9 processor without bottlenecking, so that's good news. Also, if you are a fan of NZXT, the paint job here will match your H-series casing perfectly, so you will have a very nice, homogeneous and crispy build, which we have done, so you can have a look. you thought this video is awesome, you know what to do. And also don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell. And follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans from the Mobhouse crew. And don't forget to leave a comment down below, which we will answer your comments in the comment section. And you know, ask us lah, you know, what you think about this NZXT making motherboards out of a sudden. So without further ado, comment section. First comment is from Yujan Kenjin Malapat. Do correct me if I'm butchering your name. I like the motherboard more than the processor. Actually, me too. Rohani says that you are the best gamer bangsawan. You too, bro. Matthew Ball says, do you have a link so I can shop? The link is in the description below lah, but because now shortage, it might not work, so yeah. Dope Boost said, excelente channel amigo, mucho apoyo mi encanta este canal. I think it's good because I understand excelente is good and amigo is friend, mucho is much. So yeah, thank you, bro. Ray Martala says, Intel only has better single core performance than Ryzen's previous generation chips. In multi-core performance, it's quite a different story. In fact, in this generation, Ryzen is actually still better in single core performance in a lot of cases. Mama Imran says, Sir Bangsawan, please do laptop review using the RTX 3060 GPU coming up soon. Muhammad Hidir says that he never used Intel. Is it true that it is panas? I see what you did there. Chong Hok Wah said, handsome. Thank you, baby. I'll see you tonight. So that's all for the comment session today. Leave more comments so that I can answer to more of your funny or interesting comments about the products and you can learn a few more things from the Bangsawan. And I'll see you in the next one.